Members' motions. Proposed resolution under Article 75 of the Basic Law to amend the Rules of Procedure. Members who wish to speak, please press the Request to Speak button. I now call upon Honourable Porcher to speak and move the motion. Mr. Porcher? President, as Chairman of the Committee on Rules of Procedure, move to pass the resolutions set out in the agenda and amend the Rules of Procedure of the Electoral Code of Hong Kong SAR. After approving the first two batches of amendment to the Rules of Procedure and the House Rules, the House Committee approved on the 3rd and 24th of September the third and fourth batches of amendments. There are five groups. The first group, amendments of the election procedure of the Chairman and Deputy Chairman of the House Committee and House Committee. Here are some salient points. First, members can choose to join the Finance Committee or the House Committee, but the two committees must consist of not less than 50 members, including the chairman. And as previously amended, the relevant election procedure for House Committee panels and Bills Committee would apply to the House Committee. The procedure as amended will be printed and set out in Appendix 4 of the House Rule. The second group, the proposal to amend Rule 46, Bracket 2 of the Rules of Procedure in respect of the voting procedure for members, bills, and motions so as to comply with Article 7 of the amended Annex 2 to the Basic Law. And that is to say, the motions and moved by a member who have to be voted in favor by the members of the two groups of members, that is to say the FC members and the GC members elected through direct geographical elections before the motion is passed. The third group, the proposed amendment to the resumption of a second reading debate and the consultation, the House Committee has a will be empowered to issue instructions that if two panels would like to set up a joint subcommittee, then an application can be made to the House Committee so that such a subcommittee will form under the House Committee. Second, to remove the requirement that the public officials must consult the House Committee Chairman before issuing the notice to resume the second reading. If a report from the Bills Committee has been received by the House Committee, then it would be presumed, unless otherwise decided by the House Committee, that the bill is ready for resumption for the second reading debate. The fourth group, in the light of the the public office's candidacy and taking up oath miscellaneous amendment 2021, if a member has not taken the oath or affirmation, then he should not exercise the powers and functions of a new member, and the election of the electoral president should take place before the first meeting of the council at the start of every term. The fifth group, the electoral disciplinary sanctions and remote sitting miscellaneous ordinance. In the future, the rules of procedure will be amended to make the certain financial penalty provisions. If a member is suspended because of grossly disorderly conduct, then the remuneration will be deducted. And if on a pro rata basis, and if a member is absent without valid reasons, then one day's remuneration will be deducted. And this will be come into effect on the day the 7th electoral begins. Here are my personal views on the amendment. I would like to thank the electoral secretariat and our legal advisors. Because of their hard work, we have been able to look at the rules and in question, which have presented problems over the years. You may ask why it has taken so long for us to address those problems. Well, it's because of the procedure And it, because the electrical has been taken over by some people, and therefore we were unable to do this. I would like to help the electrical secretariat staff and also members of the committee. Many members have moved the relevant amendments. I thank them all.
Mr. Tong Lijie. Thank you, President. Now, for this motion to amend the rules of procedure, is actually the fifth one in this term. Probably this will be the last motion of a similar nature. Well, there are not many amendments, but they cover a wide range of issues. Through explaining these amendments, we could help the public to revisit the absurd days of this council when the non-establishment camp hijacked the council. Now, and after the departure of those members, we could see how electrical managed to work with great efficiency and effectiveness. First, about the amendment arising from the new requirements on oaths taken by members of the council under the public officers candidacy and taking up offices, miscellaneous amendments, ordinance 2022, that had to do with the oath taking fiasco in 2016. Many of the mutual destruction camp members put up a farce at the oath-taking ceremony, you know, insulting China and so on. I'm sure you all remember vividly. The second amendment is about implementing another piece of legislation. That is, if there is grossly disorderly behavior of members, they are suspended. And also, if council meeting is aborted due to a lack of quorum because some members are absent without valid reasons, and a penalty could be imposed. In the past few years, we have seen grossly disorderly behavior of the mutual construction camp, and they started with some vile language or throwing bananas. Later on, they snatched some smartphones, they snatched documents, and then they threw materials with strong odors, and then they even assaulted some security officers. So it's actually more than just grossly disordered behavior. This is the behavior of rascals. And then they tried to, started off with some, filibustering from time to time. Eventually, there was a full-scale filibustering that's completely brought to a halt the work of the council that's severely affected people's livelihood. And then there's another amendment to about resumption of second reading of debate. You know, for House Committee, the fiasco about the election of chairman that dragged on for more than half a year. Dennis Kwok disrupted, was at the forefront of this, and then the work of the House Committee was brought to standstill, so many bills could not be considered, and including bills on paid maternity leave and so on, or waste charging. And then yesterday we passed this bill on the ban of e-cigarettes. All these bills were brought to a halt because of such disruption. Now, we are amending the election procedure for HC chairman and to avoid this from happening again. And there's another amendment about improving the operation of the new term of LegCo after reforms, because for the next term of LegCo, there will be 90 members. So the ex officio membership for HC and FC is to be replaced by voluntary option to join these two committees. But then these two committees must have at least 50 members. And also we will adjust the split voting procedures due to the return of EC members to the council. Now, the next general elections will be held in 2 months. This council will then prorogue to next week. And in the next council, I'm sure there will be many new faces. And at the same time, I believe many members will stay on too. So I hope we will take advantage of the improved electoral systems and the rules of procedure so that we could all work closely with the executive and fulfill the function of the executive and the legislature, complementing each other as well as exercising check and balance on each other. And then we could work efficiently to work for the country for Hong Kong, and then we could enhance the governance of Hong Kong as a whole. So I speak in support of the motion on behalf of the six-person member group. Dr. Lo Wai Kwok. President, we're here to consider the motion moved by Mr. Paul Chair as the Chairman of the Committee on Rules of Procedure. That is a motion to move to amend the rules of procedure in accordance with Article 75 of the Basic Law. Since the start of the term, the COB has been considering various possible amendments to the rules of procedures and House rules. On the 3rd and the 24th of September, the House Committee endorsed two more batches of amendments. Today, we are considering a fourth batch of amendments, which is about three proposed amendments to the rules of procedures and the House rules. Now, these amendments have to do with the operation of committees and also the consultation requirement for the resumption of second reading debate on the bill in the Council. Now, there will be specific provision that the House Committee has the power to consider the composition of joint committee to give directions on various matters, such as the forming of joint committee and so on. This is to ensure the smooth operation of the House Committee. And then, for issues that straddle several panels, the House Committee will have the power to form joint committee under these panels. And then the Bills Committee will have to state and report that it has completed the scrutiny of the reference bill, and that the House Committee will receive the report unless otherwise decided by the HC. The bill is regarded as ready for resumption of debate. This is another amendment. This means that after the reference officials or BC chairman consulted the House Committee, then they could give the government could give notice for resumption of second reading debate. The other amendment has to do with the public officers' candidacy and taking up offices, miscellaneous amendments, Ordinance 2021. That is, if members do not take an oath or affirmation, they shall not exercise the powers or functions of a member. The third amendment has to do with the enactment of the Legislative Council disciplinary sanctions, remote sitting, miscellaneous or amendments, Ordinance 2021, enacted in September this year. For members who've committed a grossly disorderly conduct and suspend as a result, there will be a deduction of the remuneration. And also, if a member is absent without valid reasons from a council which is adjourned due to a lack of quorum, a penalty will be imposed too. So the details are spelled out in this amendment, in this set of amendments. Now, if this council could pass this motion today, then the amended rules of procedures and house rules will commence at the start of the seventh term of LegCo. As a member of CROB, I'm glad to see this development because in the past year, we have worked very hard on these amendments. And these amendments will help to have a positive interaction between the executive and the legislature, and it will benefit good governance, and so we could all work better for the public. So I speak in support of the motion moved by Mr. Paul Chair. Mr. Jeffrey Lam, now there is an extension of a year of this term of LegCo. The establishment camp has been working hard on various issues. We have been monitoring public expenditure. We have been monitoring the policies of the government. And also, we have embarked on an exercise to amend the rules and procedures and the house rules to resume the dignity and decorum of this council. The mutual destruction camp and the opposition camp have politicized everything in this council. They put aside people's livelihood. At the peak of the of it was in 2019 when there was a violent riot, and then the mutual destruction camp works with others outside the council, and so they embarked on this mutual destruction train. Now, they abused all the rules of procedure. There was incessant calls for quorum, and then they tried every way to disrupt the election, the proceedings of the council. They held objects in this chamber. They charged at President's podium. So all these developments didn't benefit Hong Kong at all. And there was a breakdown in relations between the executive and the legislature. No policies could be taken forward. So it was a disaster. Now, we wanted to resume the decorum of this council. So we have proposed various batches of amendments to the rules of procedure and the house rules. For example, the election of the president will be held before the start of the new term. And then for those who cause some abortion meetings will be penalized. So these are just for us to put things back on the right track so we could fulfill our function in monitoring the work of the government. And then there could be positive interaction too between the government and us, and that would benefit good governance. Now, I would like to talk about our own feelings. I've been in this council for over a decade. In early days, members of this council were respected by different sectors. There was some good discussion among us. And then in recent years, external forces tried to interfere in the affairs of Hong Kong. And the mutual destruction camp was full of those who are against China and who want to cause disruption in Hong Kong. And then they went overseas to badmouth Hong Kong. And then they also hijacked this council as the platform for the confrontation. They try to, impose conspiracy theories on everything, and the image of this council was severely damaged. This is so sad. Fortunately, though, the country remains our staunchest supporter. It's trying to help us sail through. That's the enactment of the national security law, and that's improvement of the electoral system. So now there is full implementation of patriots administering Hong Kong. Hong Kong is now at a crossroad of revitalization of our economy. This is also the initial year of the 14th five-year plan. There are various opportunities presented by the Greater Bay Area Development and the Belt and Road Initiative. So the next few years will be crucial. We have to seize upon this golden opportunity to contribute to the country's development and give full play to our advantages. Now, this is important, that whether the government could have effective governance and whether we could get things done or not. So I hope that we will have regard to the actual situation and amend the rules of procedure in a pragmatic manner. Hopefully then, order will be restored and this council will be able to consider matters efficiently again. And all different parties will set aside their differences so that we could get things done for the good of the public. And then I hope members will continue to put forward constructive views and solutions to problems. I hope that very soon the Legislative Council will again be a platform for discussion of matters for the public. Thank you.
Mr. Gary Chan. Thank you, Mr. President. I'd like to thank Mr. Paul Chair of the Committee on the Rules of Procedure, for moving this motion to amend the ROP. On behalf of my party, the DAB, I'd like to indicate our support of the motion. As explained by other members, the purpose of the amendments is to plug the loopholes in the rules of procedure. For a while, the opposition camp resorted to every means to abort the meeting and block the election of President of Legislative Council and Chair of the House Committee. They blocked the procedures, and there is also this refined proposal on the membership size of committees so as to boost efficiency of the committees. So I think that this amendment exercise could help us catch up with the current situation and improve our efficiency. Like Mr. Jeffrey Lam said, in the past, there was a general perception and quite a negative one, of the Legislative Council as a place for political grandstanding. But I think in the coming term, members returned by the different channels will be able to do rework for the public and to help develop the economy instead of resorting to political attacks against each other and engage in physical combat. I want to explain that the original intention of amending the rules of procedure is to restore smooth conduct of the council meetings. But like many members said, that ROP is formed on the basis of gentlemen's agreement, where text in black and white in the ROP is rigid. We have members that can very well distort the meaning of the ROP and play tricks. They will still be able to do so, only that they will find it much more difficult. With improvements to the ROP, I suppose we'll see fewer such occasions. Now, after improving the ROP based on the gentleman's agreement, we should focus our energy on improving people's livelihood. And I believe that in the future, we will have more patriots joining the council to improve the SAR's governance and do real work for our people. Finally, I'd like to thank Chair of the CROP Committee on Rules of Procedure and the Secretariat. A lot of time has been spent on this amendment exercise, and we've had much more frequent meetings than before. So I really need to commend their time and effort in helping us. And I was also one of the members who put forward the most comments in this exercise. But I was only speaking on behalf of the pro-establishment camp. So for members of the pro-establishment camp, they are in full support of the amendments to the ROP. We need to go back to our original intention, and that is to work hard towards improving the SAR government's governance and for effective conduct of the council so that we can truly have a gentleman's agreement in this council. Does any other member wish to speak? If not, I will invite Mr. Paul Chair to respond and then the debate will come to a close. Mr. Paul Chair, like Mr. Gary Chen said, Mr. President, the rules are written in black and white. They are rigid, but in terms of implementation of the rules, we need continuous improvement. I hope this is not the end of our exercise this time, and we do have the duty of continually reviewing the operation, and if need be, we'll need to tap collective wisdom to continue to improve the ROP. Very often, our committee works behind closed doors. It doesn't attract a lot of public attention. We will look at research in overseas practices. So members of the public may wonder what our work exactly is. I thank Dr. Lo Wai Kwok, Mr. Horace Cheung, and other members for helping us with the amendments during this term. And I'd like to thank the President again, because as a matter of practice, the President also provided a lot of useful advice on the proposed amendments through the Secretariat. And in fact, the Secretariat also gave us a lot of invaluable suggestions. Now, yesterday, when Dr. Pierre Chan, one of our members, spoke, he said that the bill would be passed because we no longer had the opposition camp over there. And he even made this gesture. And I am shocked because, indeed, we don't have members on the other side now. These members were quite radicals, and they were in the opposition camp. But all we seek to do is to ensure impartiality, fairness, and efficiency of our meetings so that the council's business can be handled in such a manner. Now, for the opposing views, let me also explain about them. According to the mechanism, If you wish to move a motion, a split voting is required. And if you're not able to get support from both sides of the council, you won't get through. So previously, no amendment was proposed because at the end of the day, the amendments will not be passed because of the split voting procedure. On this occasion, we are going to clear up all the mess in one go, including bodily conflicts, filibustering at the council meetings, and blockage of election of chair of the House committee. It's like a rebirth for us. We're trying to clear up the mess in one go. And then I think that with more members joining the council, we need to ensure fairness in our procedures. Some may wonder whether we are being too stringent. I want to reassure members of the public that all amendments that we propose, which would be passed, will have been discussed by members having considered practices in other countries. They may have even older traditions for members engaging in grossly misconduct behavior. Apart from evicting them from the chamber, we also have a financial penalty. This is based on the reference made to the UK Parliament, which imposes an even harder punishment for filibustering on with good intention. For example, if you want to draw the public's attention, filibustering is acceptable. However, we don't accept the Taliban style in the all-out filibustering. Now, is it that we won't be able to monitor the government? According to the experience in the past decade, as long as we don't focus our energy on the political grandstanding and attracting the public's attention, we will be able to focus our energy on discussing the merits of government policies, and then we'll be able to enhance efficiency, and then the public officers will play a more active role as well, because they won't be afraid of receiving personal attacks. So in terms of public offices, and other political talents who are aspired, I hope that they would be more reassured to join us, be it in the council or be it the government, so that they could continue to serve the public. This is the most important highlight of this amendment exercise. This is just the first step, and we will be moving to the subsequent steps later. Once again, I thank the Secretariat and the Legal Research Division of the Legislative Council for the contribution. Thank you.
And I'll put a question to you that Honourable Paul Chair's motion be passed. Does any member, with those in favour, please raise their hand. Those against, please raise their hand. I think the question is agreed by majority each of the two groups of members. I declare the motion passed. After a three-day meeting, we have handled all the items with legislative effect. This council will now adjourn until the 11 p.m. on the 27th of October, 2021.